It is a Thanksgiving Eve tradition that draws thousands. Tonight is the 33rd annual Guns and Hoses event. Fox 2's Katie Kormann is live at the Enterprise Center now, where the police officers and firefighters are squaring off for a good cause. Katie?
Mandy, these folks here in the crowd have seen several really good fights already tonight. They just wrapped up the MMA fight where a St. Louis County police officer was victorious. It was a battle, a big, big battle. But there are a lot of people here tonight. This is definitely the biggest event in town tonight. More than 18,000 people expected to be here for this sold out event. It has been sold out now for 4 years in a row. Tonight's event, 15 fights, 3 matches per fight. The blue team, the red team. It's all consisting of a mixture of first responders from across the region. All the hard work, blood, sweat, and even some tears, all in support of the backstoppers and the families of first responders who have died or been catastrophically injured in the line of duty. To date, Guns N' Hoses has raised $7.6 million for the backstoppers. 7 first responders are recognized this year. Many of them had families, wives, and children. But how exactly does money raised at events like Guns N' Hoses benefit these families? Whitney Hopkins, wife of Illinois State Trooper Nick Hopkins, talk to me about the first meeting she had with a representative of Backstoppers just days after her husband was killed in the line of duty.
We're here for you. We're here to support you, and we'll do whatever you need us to do, pretty much. And so I'm like, okay, what exactly does that mean? And he said your mortgage will be paid off. Your bills will be paid off. We will take care of you.
So just remember, anytime you are donating to an organization like Backstoppers, that money going to support Whitney, her children, and all of the other families of those fallen first responders. Last year, this event had $800,000 in donations. The event organizers tell me they are hopeful this year we'll raise even more. We'll be back with you live at 10 o'clock with more updates from this year's Guns N' Hoses. For now, we're live at the Enterprise Center. Katie Kormann, Fox 2 News.